Doctors scrub in, equipment is scrubbed out.
Wipe off the outside until there's no more visible debris.
In fact, it takes longer to clean this scope than it does for doctors to perform the procedure.
I'd say I do 300 to 400 a year.
Dr. Michael Schaefer is talking about endoscopic procedures, the same ones done at UCLA's Ronald Reagan Medical Center. Nearly 200 patients were exposed to a dangerous and deadly bacteria. Officials blame contaminated equipment. Dr. Schaefer tells me all gastroenterologists use the duodenoscope.
There's a small elevator that those other scopes don't have that allow us to maneuver certain instruments within the small intestine.
But says that device is hard to keep clean.
How the scope is designed, there's crevices in there.
It's also a long tube with tiny parts. The plastic cannot be heated for sterilization, so it's scrubbed, brushed, flushed, disinfected.
And it forces water and air through the scope at a high rate.
Mary Hawkins helps to oversee the sterilization at Methodist. She says more than ever, Methodist does not reuse if they don't have to.
We don't bother with that. There are, there's lots of things that can be reprocessed. We just use the disposable whenever we can, wherever we can.
Methodist surgical staff also test cleaning solution every time to make sure it's as potent as can be. When dealing with a device like the duodenoscope, it can easily become a device carrying deadly contamination.
We actually started doing prior to that whole process coming out. We reprocess our scopes. What's every